done and what should not be done. Anyway, I'll speak about, of course, these five M's are important, and I would like to add some more dimensions to excellence, and they may not be all, but still, I would add leadership in this. I would add strategic planning, customer focus, information and analysis, human resource development, process management, and they all leading to improved result. So that's the kind of framework which was adopted by Tata Business Excellence Model on the basis of what is a very well-known model of Malcolm Baldrige. Now, Malcolm Baldrige, you must have all heard about the award which was instituted after his name on quality management. This fellow used to be the Secretary of Commerce in the government of United States in the time of Ronald Reagan, and he was the proponent of quality management in the United Nations, United States of America, and he became famous for this. So these are a number of things which are there and needs to be considered. When I heard about this theme of excellence, business excellence, I was reminded of a very good conversation we had with Professor Mashelkar, R.A. Mashelkar, who had retired as Director General of CSIR, and he suggested a term, what he called affordable excellence. Now, he said that he believed that high technology should be used to make things affordable. I mean, not it should not be just for the rich, but should be for the poor also. And he said it should be different from what we are famous for, Jugaad. Now, that Jugaad thing is not really excellence, and we should move away from, move above it, and we should include the excellence and high technology, high science into making things which are affordable to everyone. And he instituted an award named after his mother, and he gave an example of a 28-year old boy. His name was Mishkin Ingewala, and this boy observed that the women in villages were very much shy of giving blood samples for any investigation. So he developed a non-invasive diagnostic tool to detect hemoglobin, because this hemoglobin, low hemoglobin, was a very common thing, and he used very advanced scientific techniques and software to create what he called TouchHB, T-O-U-C-H and B, B, small b, that is for hemoglobin. And this would cost only 10 rupees, which is about 1/10 of the cost of a normal test. So it was a technological excellence, and there was no Jugaad in this. Now, this affordable excellence was, as he said, was a result of the income equality, and it needed this affordable excellence to create high quality equality. That's what he said, that everyone should be able to afford the results of technological excellence. Now, C.K. Prahlad was impressed by this idea, and they did a paper together, and that was in the year 2010. And it was published in the Harvard Business Review in 2010, and in which they propounded a concept, a very simple concept called MLM paradigm. More from less for more. More from less for more. And after it was published in Harvard Business Review, it attracted international attention. And this, there was a special session on MLM in the World Economic Conference in 2010. Now, this idea spread not only in the emerging countries, but in the developed world also. Now, we have all heard about Jeffrey Immelt of General Electric, and he said that if we do not come up with innovations in poor countries and take them globally, then our new competitors will do so. And he was really not wrong. Now, do you know that Mahindra and Mahindra small tractors are being sold to American hobby farmers, and they are giving competition to the world leader John Deere. They are taking away their market share in United States. There are companies in China, Hires, for example, is selling white goods at half the price of the American goods. So the multinationals are getting worried on this account, and General Electric itself started making these portable ultrasound machines in China, which would sell for $1,500 against the price of $20,000 in the United States. Similarly, in Bangalore, they are they started making very high quality these ECG instruments for $600 with a normal price of $10,000 in the United States. So that's a concept which is taking off, and it is being recognized. And not only the corporates, there are many other examples. The top economists of the world are also researching affordable excellence. Now, there is a very famous scientist at Harvard called George Whiteside. He developed an inexpensive detector costing just $25, which can be used by these healthcare workers in the poorest areas of the world